Now, many of us had an overwhelming urge to blur the last couple of months with a lot of screen time and a sometimes dubious diet.
So, how are we going to go when things return to normal? Will our little lockdown habits be hard to shake? Here's Lucas de Jong.
It's been 7 weeks. Seven long, bubble-bound weeks. And that means we've developed some...
Don't judge me.
...questionable habits.
Around 40% of the behaviours that we do are habits, and that basically means that they almost happen without thinking about it.
Registered nutritionalist Claire Turnbull is an expert in habitual behaviour and how we can break the bad and boost the good.
When you repeat the same behaviour over and over again, your brain will anticipate that behaviour happening and it creates a craving. So you almost are powerless over some of your habits.
How do we beat them?
Wake up, Lockie, they need you for the show.
Easy, just expose your eyes.
A lot of people are not getting outside early enough in the morning, which completely dysregulates your circadian rhythm.
Looks like rain.
So what we need to be doing is making sure we're exposing our eyes to natural light, so no sunglasses on, early in the morning. And that basically signals the brain it's daytime. And then it also says to the brain in around 12 to 16 hours, you need to release melatonin so that you can actually go to sleep nicely at bedtime.
Get into a nighttime routine.
So people at the moment tend to have a very irregular bedtime. If you've not got to get up first thing in the morning, it's easy to, you know, watch TV, be scrolling really late at night. So number one is make sure you're going to bed at the same time. Very, very important. The second thing is including a wind down routine. So that could be having a shower before bed. And the other thing is reducing your exposure to blue light in the evening. So checking the settings on your phone, laptops, turn them down, and just not doing that late night scrolling.
Why not reorganize your pantry?
Over the last couple of weeks, people have definitely been eating a little bit more, you know, baking a little bit more.
Not that disgusting.
Lots of picking, nibbling, and because, you know, you're feeling a bit sad and, you know, life's a bit rubbish, it's really easy to justify eating those extra biscuits and treats. So the key thing is to try and make it more difficult to access some of those foods and drinks you want to be having less of. If you've got any biscuits or treats, put them up high so you literally have to go on a chair to reach them. Put the wine out of the fridge so it's not cold. So on the other side of that, it's making the healthier food and healthier drinks more accessible. So getting those chopped up veggies in the front of the fridge so that the first thing that you see.
And finally, trigger a bit of exercise.
So a lot of people have lost the habit loop with exercise because two very strong anchors for exercise are a time and a location. If you're still at home, it's committing to doing the exercise, whether it's running around your garden, going for a walk, doing some squats in the backyard at a specific time of day. Make it a calendar appointment, and if you can, try and do it at the same time as someone else or check in for a bit of accountability.
And with bad habits gone and good ones in hand, you'll be ready to take on the world. Or at least a 10-person picnic.
Oh, look at that. He's a different person. I've been struggling. For me, the brownie. I mean, I've been eating four of these a day.
You do love a sweet treat.
Yeah, I love a sweet treat.
Lot of sweet treats.
I've tried to put them up high, but they just keep finding their way down low the whole time.
It's because you're so tall.
Yeah, doesn't help really, does it?
I've actually been really good this lockdown. I tried desperately not to be as bad as I was the previous lockdown.
Really?
So that's... Yeah, no, I've
been really,
really
good.
Really, really good.
What's behind you?
Nothing.
What's behind you?
No need. No, don't you put your hand back there. OK, I might have a packet of lollies, but I really, really like the milk bottles.
You're a big fan of milk bottles.
Don't you love the milk bottles? Sorry.